I was playing with some other kids just outside the south wall. I was trying to teach them how to do the air scooter. First, you form the ball. Then you gotta get on quick.
Yeah! Oh, yeah!
Okay, here goes.
Quick, get on! You kinda have to balance on it like it's a top.
Man, that's hard.
Where'd you learn that trick, Aang? I made it up.
Wow!
Aang, come with us. We need to speak with you.
How do you know it's me?
We have known you were the Avatar for some time. Do you remember these?
Those were some of my favorite toys when I was little.
You chose them from among thousands of toys, Aang. The toys you picked were the four Avatar relics. These items belong to Avatar's past, your own past lives.
I just chose them because they seemed fun.
You chose them because they were familiar.
Normally, we would have told you of your identity when you turned 16, but there are troubling signs. Storm clouds are gathering.
I fear that war may be upon us, young Avatar.
We need you, Aang.
Hey, not bad. You guys have been practicing.
Not only that, we made up a game you can play with the air scooters. Great!
What's going on?
Now that you're the Avatar, it's kind of an unfair advantage for whichever team you're on.
But I'm still the same. Nothing's changed. So what? I can't play?
That's the only fair way.
Oh, okay. Sorry, Aang.
Okay, now who wants to have Jinju on their team?
Very interesting move, young one.
What do you mean? Hey.
You're playing games with him? The Avatar should be training.
Aang has already trained enough for today.
Time is short. Come with me. I must test you on some high-level techniques.
No. As long as I am his guardian, I will decide when he trains. And when he gets his butt kicked at Pai Shou. Aang needs to have freedom and fun. He needs to grow up as a normal boy.
You cannot keep protecting him from his destiny.
Gyatso, I know you mean well, but you are letting your affection for the boy cloud your judgment.
All I want is what is best for him.
But what we need is what's best for the world. You and Aang must be separated. The Avatar will be sent away to the Eastern Air Temple to complete his training.
I was afraid and confused. I didn't know what to do.
I'm not going to let them take you away from me. Aang?
I never saw Gyatso again. I was waking up in your arms after you found me in the iceberg.
There is a storm coming. A big one.
You're out of your mind, Uncle. The weather's perfect. There's not a cloud in sight.
A storm is approaching from the north. I suggest we alter our course and head southwest.
We know the Avatar is traveling northward, so we will do the same.
Prince Zuko, consider the safety of the crew.
The safety of the crew doesn't matter.
Finding the Avatar is far more important than any individual's safety.
He doesn't mean that. He's just all worked up.
Looks like your uncle was right about the storm after all.
Lucky guess.
Lieutenant, you'd better learn some respect, or I will teach it to you.
What do you know about respect? The way you talk to everyone around here, from your hard-working crew to your esteemed uncle, shows you know nothing about respect. You don't care about anyone but yourself. Then again, what should I expect from a spoiled prince?
Easy now. Enough! We're all a bit tired from being at sea so long. I'm sure after a bowl of noodles, everyone will feel much better.
I don't need your help keeping order on my ship.
I'm sick of taking his orders, and I'm tired of chasing his avatar. I mean, who does Zuko think he is?
Do you really want to know?
General Iroh, we were just...
It's okay. May I join you?
Of course, sir.
Try to understand. My nephew is a complicated young man. He has been through much.
Let me in!
Prince Zuko. What's wrong?
I want to go into the war chamber, but the guard won't let me pass.
You're not missing anything, trust me. These meetings are dreadfully boring.
If I'm going to rule this nation one day, don't you think I need to start learning as much as I can?
Very well. But you must promise not to speak. These old folks are a bit sensitive, you know.
Thank you, Uncle.
The Earth Kingdom defenses are concentrated here. A dangerous battalion of their strongest earthbenders and fiercest warriors. So I am recommending the 41st Division.
But the 41st is entirely new recruits. How do you expect them to defeat a powerful Earth Kingdom battalion?
I don't. They'll be used as a distraction while we mount an attack from the rear. What better to use as bait than fresh meat?
You can't sacrifice an entire division like that. Those soldiers love and defend our nation. How can you betray them?
Zuko was right, you see. But it was not his place to speak out. And there were dire consequences. After Zuko's outburst in the meeting, the Fire Lord became very angry with him. Said that Prince Zuko's challenge of the general was an act of complete disrespect. And there was only one way to resolve this.
Agni Kai, a fire duel.
That's right. Zuko looked upon the old general he had insulted and declared that he was not afraid. But Zuko misunderstood. When he turned to face his opponent, he was surprised to see it was not the general. Zuko had spoken out against the general's plan, but by doing so in the Fire Lord's war room, it was the Fire Lord whom he had disrespected. Zuko would have to duel his own father. When Prince Zuko saw that it was his father who had come to duel him, he begged for mercy.
Please, Father, I only had the Fire Nation's best interest at heart. I'm sorry I spoke out of turn.
You will fight for your honor.
I meant you no disrespect. I am your loyal son.
Rise and fight, Prince Zuko.
I won't fight you.
You will learn respect, and suffering will be your teacher.
I looked away.
That Prince Zuko was in a training accident.
It was no accident. After the duel, the Fire Lord said that by refusing to fight, Zuko had shown shameful weakness. As punishment, he was banished and sent to capture the Avatar. Only then could he return with his honor.
So that's why he's so obsessed. Capturing the Avatar is the only chance he has of things returning to normal.
Things will never return to normal. But the important thing is, the Avatar gives Zuko hope.
We need to get this ship to safety.
Then we must head directly into the eye of the storm.
Who's this Aang kid you keep talking about, Your Highness?
I want a full transcription of my speech sent to the Fire Lord, along with glowing testimonials from all of the ranking officers present, and...
Sir, shall I hold off sending that speech to the Fire Lord?
Avatar must be captured alive!
Open the gate.
Admiral, what are you doing?
Let them out. Now!
How could you let them go?
A situation like this requires precision. Do you have a clear shot? Knock out the thief. I'll deliver him to the Fire Lord along with the Avatar.
Quick! Recover the Avatar!
Can your science explain why it rains?
Yes! Yes, it can!
They just won't listen to reason.
But they will listen to Aunt Wu.
I know, that's the problem.
Well, it's about to become the solution. We're taking fate in our own hands. First, they need to borrow Aunt Wu's cloud reading book. Anyone to hear us. Oh! Oh, I didn't see you there.
You don't like me, do you?
Of course I like you.
But not the way I like you.
Oh, I guess not.
It's okay. It's just really hard when you like someone, but they don't think of you that way.
I know what you mean.
She's beautiful, by the way.
Huh?
That Water Tribe girl. I can see why you like her so much. She's sweet, she's a bender, and her hair seems so manageable.
Don't worry. You're gonna meet a great guy who's gonna completely fall for you. I know it.
Thanks. Wait, don't you want this?
How did you know?
I've kind of been stalking you. Heh.
Oh, thanks. I guess. Clouds are made of water and air, so between the two of us, we ought to be able to bend them into any shape we want.
I found it! The symbol for volcanic doom.
Something's happening in the clouds.
That's very strange. It shouldn't.
Oh my!
We can still save the village if we act fast. Sokka has a plan.
Lava is gonna flow downhill to this spot. If we can dig a deep enough trench, we can channel all the lava away from the village to the river.
If any of you are earthbenders, come with me.
I'm an earthbender. I'm not!
Everybody else, grab a shovel! Come on, we've got to hurry!
Come for you when it's safe!
too much! It's gonna overflow!
Sometimes I forget what a powerful bender that kid is.
Wait, what did you just say?
Nothing, just that Aang is one powerful bender.
I suppose he is.
By the way, we kind of borrowed your book.
So you messed with the clouds, did you? Very clever.
No offense, but I hope this has taught everyone a lesson about not relying too much on fortune-telling.
But Aunt Wu predicted the village wouldn't be destroyed, and it wasn't. She was right, after all.
I hate you.
It's okay, Sokka. Everything's gonna be all right.
Can I ask you something?
Of course, honey.
You didn't really see love in my fortune, did you? You just told me what I wanted to hear.
I'll tell you a little secret, young airbender. Just as you reshape those clouds, you have the power to shape your own destiny.
Goodbye, everyone. It was so nice to meet you. Take care, Meng.
Take care. Floozy.
So this is your girlfriend. No wonder she left. She's way too pretty for you.
Where is he? Where's the Avatar? We split up. He's long gone. How stupid do you think I am?
Pretty stupid.
Run! What are we supposed to do now?
It's seeking a different scent. Perhaps something that the Avatar held.
What's it doing? It's just going in a circle.
No!
Aang!
Get some feeling back. Ow.
Ah.
fancies with its nose. Let's give him something to look at.
The perfume?
So, where do we go?
We're getting you to the North Pole.
Yeah. We've lost too much time as it is.
Don't you want to see your father?
Of course we do, Aang. But you're our family, too. And right now, you need us more.
And we need you.
I wish I could give you a little piece of home, Katara. Something to remind you...
I'll be okay.
Still, just a little trinket. Maybe something like this?
Aang! How'd you get that?
Zuko asked me to be sure I got it to you.
Oh, that's so sweet of Zuko. Would you give him a kiss for me when you see him?
Sure.
Mwah.
Have healing abilities. The great benders of the water tribe sometimes have this ability. I've always wished I were blessed like you, free from this burning curse.
But you're a great master. You have powers I'll never know.
Water brings healing and life, but fire brings only destruction and pain. It forces those of us burdened with its care to walk a razor's edge between humanity and savagery. Eventually, we are torn apart. Go get your friends and flee! Do not come back here, or you will all be destroyed! Hurry!
Gave up fighting a long time ago.
Haven't you, Master Zhang Zhang?
Katara, are you all right?
I'm fine. We've got to get out of here. Where's Aang?
Zhang Zhang tried to tell me that I wasn't ready. I wouldn't listen. I'm never gonna firebend again.
You'll have to eventually.
No, never again.
It's okay, Aang. I'm healed.
What? How?
I'll explain later. But right now, we have to get out of here. Zhao and his soldiers are attacking.
Where?
By the river. They captured Zhang Zhang.
I have to help him!
Look at you. You were once so great. I can't believe my former master has become nothing more than a simple savage.
It is you who have embraced savagery, Zhao.
It's Admiral Zhao now.
That title will not help you against the Avatar. Do not try to fight him. You are no match.
I think I can handle a child.
I have never seen such raw power.
Zhang Zhang!
We'll see. Men, take the deserter.
It's a trick! He's run off into the woods. Find him!
Let's find out what my old master has taught you.
You were Zhang Zhang's student?
Until I got bored.
Ah!
I see he taught you how to duck and run like a coward, but I doubt he showed you what a firebender is truly capable of.
Whoa, wild shot!
I'll show you wild!
No self-control.
Stand and fight, Avatar!
Oh, were we fighting? I thought you were just getting warmed up.
I was.
Is that all you got? Man, they'll make anyone an admiral these days. Ahoy! I'm Admiral Zhao. I don't know why, but I thought you'd be better than Zuko. Sloppy. Very sloppy.
Nowhere to run now, you little smart mouth.
You've lost this battle.
Are you crazy? You haven't thrown a single blow.
No. But you had. Zhang Zhang said you had no restraint. Have a nice walk home.
Aang, come on. Let's go.
Wait, where's Zhang Zhang?
He disappeared. They all did.
Hey, where'd everybody go? Very funny, guys.
Aang, you're burned. Let me help you.
That's good water.
When did you learn how to do that?
I guess I always knew.
Oh, well then thanks for all the first aid over the years. Like when I fell into the greaseberry bramble, and that time I had two fish hooks in my thumb.
Two? He tried to get the first fish hook out with another fish hook.
Oh, and the time that mink snake bit me. Thanks for healing that up. That was great. Really helpful.
You're a real airbender. You must be the Avatar. That's amazing. I've heard stories about you.
Thanks.
Wow, this glider chair is incredible.
You'd think this is good. Wait until you see the other stuff my dad designed. That is the mastermind behind this whole place. Everything's powered by hot air. It even pumps hot air currents outside to give us a lift when we're gliding.
This place is unbelievable.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it?
No, just unbelievable.
Aang used to come here a long time ago. I think he's a little shocked it's so different.
So better?
This is supposed to be the history of my people.
Some parts of the temple are still the same.
It's nice to see at least one part of the temple that isn't ruined.
Look out!
What the doodle? Don't you know enough to stay away from construction sites? We have to make room for the bathhouse.
Do you know what you did? You just destroyed something sacred for a stupid bathhouse.
Well, people around here are starting to stink.
This whole place stinks. This is a sacred temple. You can't treat it this way. I've seen it when the monks were here. I know what it's supposed to be like.
The monks? But you're 12.
Dad, he's the Avatar. He used to come here 100 years ago.
What are you doing? Who said you could be here?
Doing here a long time ago, but not 100 years. My people became refugees after a terrible flood. My infant son, Teo, was badly hurt and lost his mother. I needed somewhere to rebuild, and I stumbled across this place. Couldn't believe it. Everywhere, pictures of flying people, but empty, nobody home. Then I came across these fan-like contraptions.
Our gliders?
Yes, little light flying machines. They gave me an idea. Build a new life for my son in the air. Then everyone would be on equal ground, so to speak. We're just in the process of improving upon what's already here. And after all, isn't that what nature does?
Nature knows where to stop.
I suppose that's true. Unfortunately, progress has a way of getting away from us. Look at the time. Come, the pulley system must be oiled before dark.
Wait, how can you tell the time from that thing? The notches all look the same.
The candle will tell us. Watch.
You put spark powder in the candle.
4 flashes, so it's exactly 4 hours past midday, or as I call it, 4 o'candle. If you like that, wait till you see my finger-safe knife sharpener. Only took me 3 tries to get it right. Follow me.
Hey, Aang, I want to show you something.
I just can't get over it. There's not a single thing that's the same.
I don't know about that. The temple might be different, but the creatures that live here are probably direct descendants of the ones that lived here a long time ago.
You're right. They're kind of keepers of the temple's origins.
Besides, there is one part of the temple that hasn't changed at all.
Hey, it's just like the one in the other air temple.
Only an airbender can open it. So inside, it's completely untouched, just the way the monks left it. I've always wondered what it was like in there.
Aang? I'm sorry. This is the last part of the temple that's the same as it was. I want it to stay that way.
I completely understand. I just wanted you to know it was here.
Thanks.
You're not gonna win this fight!
I know! I don't care!
You don't have to do this for me. I can find another teacher.
I'm not doing it for you. Someone needs to slap some sense into that guy. So, you decided to show up? Aren't you gonna fight?
Go back to the healing huts with the other women where you belong. Fine. You want to learn to fight so bad? Study closely. Don't worry, I'm not going to hurt you.
Ah.
Well, I'm impressed. You are an excellent waterbender.
But you still won't teach me, will you?
No. This fight is over.
Come back here! I'm not finished yet!
Yes, you are. This is my necklace.
No, it's not. It's mine. Give it back!
I made this 60 years ago. For the love of my life. For Kama.
My grand-gran was supposed to marry you?
Our plan is working perfectly. Zhao doesn't suspect a thing.
You didn't have to do this.
No nephew of mine is going to stow away on a ship without some backup.
Thank you, Uncle.
Someone's coming. Stay hidden until we get to the North Pole, and the Avatar will be yours. Good luck.
I carved this necklace for your grandmother when we got engaged. I thought we would have a long, happy life together. I loved her.
But she didn't love you, did she? It was an arranged marriage. Grand-gran wouldn't let your tribe's stupid customs run her life. That's why she left. It must have taken a lot of courage.
Go get her.
Is he okay? He's crossing into the spirit world. He'll be fine as long as we don't move his body. That's his way back to the physical world.
Maybe we should get some help.
No, he's my friend. I'm perfectly capable of protecting him.
Well, aren't you a big girl now?
No.
Yes. Hand him over, and I won't have to hurt you. I see you've learned a new trick. But I didn't come this far to lose to you.
You little peasant. You found a master, haven't you?
Daybreak at last. Let's write history.
You rise with the moon. I rise with the sun.
Tribe can try to resist the inevitable, but their city will fall today.
Aang!
What happened? Where's Zuko?
He took Aang. He took him right out from under me.
Where did they go?
Hello? I'm sorry to disturb you. I just really need to find the moon and the ocean spirits.
Go away. You're still here?
Yes, I need...
Oh! Perhaps that thing will help you. Chase it. Finally.
Water tribe is under attack. I need to find the ocean and the moon spirits.
The ocean and the moon are ancient spirits. They crossed over from the spirit world to the mortal world very near the beginning. There is only one spirit I know of who is old enough to remember.
Who?
The spirit's name is Ko, but he is very dangerous. They call him the Face Stealer. When you speak with him, you must be very careful to show no emotion at all, not the slightest expression, or he will steal your face.
Curly tail, blue nose.
Show no fear. Show no emotion at all.
Hello? I'm looking for a spirit named Ko.
You, one of your previous incarnations, tried to slay me, maybe 800 or 900 years ago.
I didn't know that. Why did he or I try to kill you?
Oh, it was something about stealing the face of someone you loved. Of course, that's all behind us. Why should I hold a grudge against you for something in a past life? After all, you're a different person now. You've come to me with a new face.
Guess we'll be here a while.
Don't worry. Prince Zuko can't be getting too far in this weather.
I'm not worried they'll get away in the blizzard. I'm worried that they won't.
They're not gonna die in this blizzard. If we know anything, it's that Zuko never gives up. They'll survive, and we'll find them.
It's been a long time since I've added a child's face to my collection. So, how may I help you?
I need to find the moon and the ocean.
Their spirit names are Twi and La, push and pull. And that has been the nature of their relationship for all time.
Please, help me find them. An entire culture could be destroyed if I don't get their help.
Oh, you think you need their help? Actually, it's quite the other way around. Someone is going to kill them!
What do you mean? How can I find them and protect them?
You've already met them, actually. Twi and La, your moon and ocean, have always circled each other in an eternal dance. They balance each other, push and pull, life and death, good and evil, yin and yang.
The koi fish!
I must be going now.
We'll meet again.
The spirits are in trouble. I need to get back to the physical world.
A friend is here to guide you back.
Hey, bye! This is where I came in. But how do I get back?
Good riddance.
Momo? Oh no, where's my body? Look, that's gotta be Aang! Yep, yep!
Welcome back.
Good to be back.
That won't be enough to escape.
Appa!
Whoa! Here for a rematch?
Trust me, Zuko. It's not gonna be much of a match.
Hey, this is some quality rope.
We need to get to the oasis. The spirits are in trouble. Wait, we can't just leave him here.
Sure we can. Let's go.
No. If we leave him, he'll die.
Yeah, this makes a lot of sense. Let's bring the guy who's constantly trying to kill us.
Are you okay?
I feel faint.
I feel it too. The moon spirit is in trouble.
I owe the moon spirit my life.
What do you mean?
When I was born, I was very sick and very weak. Most babies cry when they're born. But I was born as if I were asleep, my eyes closed. Our healers did everything they could. They told my mother and father I was going to die. My father pleaded with the spirits to save me. That night, beneath the full moon, he brought me to the oasis and placed me in the pond. My dark hair turned white. I opened my eyes and began to cry. And they knew I would live. That's why my mother named me Yue, for the moon.
I am a legend now.
The Fire Nation will for generations tell stories about the great Zhao who darkened the moon. They will call me Zhao the Conqueror. Zhao the Moon Slayer! Zhao the Invincible! Get it off! Get it off! Don't bother.
Zhao! Don't!
It's my destiny to destroy the moon and the Water Tribe.
Destroying the moon won't hurt just the Water Tribe. It will hurt everyone, including you. Without the moon, everything would fall out of balance. You have no idea what kind of chaos that would unleash on the world.
He is right, Zhao.
General Iroh, why am I not surprised to discover your treachery?
I'm no traitor, Zhao. The Fire Nation needs the moon, too. We all depend on the balance. Whatever you do to that spirit, I'll unleash on you tenfold! Let it go now!
Ah!
There's no hope now. It's over.
No, it's not over.
Did. You're the Blue Spirit, an enemy of the Fire Nation. You freed the Avatar.
I had no choice.
You should have chosen to accept your failure, your disgrace. Then, at least, you could have lived.
It's too late. It's dead.
You have been touched by the Moon Spirit. Some of its life is in you.
Yes, you're right. It gave me life. Maybe I can give it back.
No! You don't have to do that!
It's my duty, Sokka.
I won't let you! Your father told me to protect you!
I have to do this.
She's gone. She's gone.
Goodbye, Sokka. I'll always be with you.
Thank you.
I've decided to go to the South Pole. Some other benders and healers want to join me. It's time we helped rebuild our sister tribe.
What about Aang? He still needs to learn waterbending.
Well, then he better get used to calling you Master Katara.
The spirits gave me a vision when Yue was born. I saw a beautiful, brave young woman become the moon spirit. I knew this day would come.
You must be proud.
So proud and sad.
I'm surprised, Prince Zuko. Surprised that you are not at this moment trying to capture the Avatar.
I'm tired.
Then you should rest. A man needs his rest.
You too, Momo.
Come here.
Iroh is a traitor, and your brother Zuko is a failure. I have a task for you.